Hi everyone, Greg Meskel here for Lakers Nation. If you haven't been following the NBA for very long, you might think of NBA Hall of Famer Pat Riley as someone only associated with the Miami Heat. And while he has won three championships with the Heat as coach and team president, longtime Lakers fans know that before all of that, Riley had established himself as one of the greatest Lakers coaches ever. And since this is Lakers Nation, we're going to take a look back at the top Riley moments in Lakers history. No Heat, no Knicks, all Lakers. Here we go. In at number 5, we go back to 1972. Before Pat Riley ever coached the Lakers, he played for them. In the 1971-72 season, Riley was a key role player for the Purple and Gold, coming off the bench to average around 7 points per game. He helped the team to the NBA Finals where they knocked off the Knicks in 5 games. This gave Riley and the city of Los Angeles their first NBA title, something that would repeat itself many times. At number 4, we fast forward to Riley's coaching days in the 1981-82 season. Riley started the year as a team broadcaster, but 6 games into the season, Magic Johnson asked to be traded rather than play for coach Paul Westhead. This led to Westhead being fired and a bizarre press conference in which Jerry West and Riley were named co-head coaches by owner Dr. Jerry Buss. West made it clear he would only assist Riley, and the Showtime era was underway. Riley proceeded to guide the Lakers to an NBA championship in just his first season, topping the Philadelphia 76ers as Riley's dominant run in the 80s began. In at number 3, we move to the 1984-85 season. A year after losing to the Celtics in the NBA Finals, Riley guided the Lakers back for another meeting with the Celtics in 1985. History was weighing on the Lakers, who had failed to beat Boston in 8 previous attempts for an NBA title. The first year of the 2-3-2 format, the Lakers were hammered in Game 1, 148-114, in what became known as the Memorial Day Massacre. But Riley regrouped his team, and the Lakers won 4 of the next 5 games to take the series and the championship. It was the Lakers' 3rd title in 6 years. At number 2 is not any one particular moment, but more of a movement. They called it Showtime. While Dr. Jerry Buss is to be given a great deal of credit for making the environment around the court at the Great Western Forum full of glitz and glamour, Pat Riley and former head coach Jack McKinney should be credited for the run-and-gun style on the court, powered by the likes of Magic Johnson, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, James Worthy, Michael Cooper, and many more. The Lakers revolutionized the fast break with no-look passes, powerful dunks, and a highlight reel of plays every time they took the floor. Last but certainly not least is the 12-month period from June 1987 to June 1988 that saw Riley take the Lakers to back-to-back NBA championships, the first NBA team to accomplish the feat in 20 years. The 1986-87 season featured the most dominant Lakers team of the decade as they turned in a 65-17 record on the way to beating the Celtics in 6 games. Riley was so confident in his team that he guaranteed a Lakers repeat, and they made him look good as they captured a hard-fought 7-game victory over the rising Detroit Pistons. It marked Riley's 4th title as Lakers head coach and cemented the Lakers as the dominant team of the decade. Riley would get the Lakers back to the finals the following year, and despite copyrighting the term three-peat in the offseason, he wouldn't get a chance to use it as the Pistons returned with a series sweep for the title. Riley would leave the Lakers after the next season, but not before being named NBA Coach of the Year for the first time. How Riley never won the award before is one of the bigger mysteries of the 80s, along with Who Shot JR? It's an old TV reference. Riley goes down as a Laker legend, from the development of Showtime to forcing coaches everywhere to dress a lot nicer. We were talking Armani suits, and what guy, well maybe except me, you might get the idea, didn't attempt slicking back their hair in Riley fashion. He even had his own video game on Sega Genesis called Pat Riley Basketball. All in all, a pretty impressive resume. Now it's your turn, Lakers Nation. What do you think? What was Pat Riley's greatest moment with the Lakers? Let us know down in the comments section or tweet at us at Lakers Nation. Thanks for watching.